Today is Wednesday, the 20th of October. We give God all the glory for the gift of life. Hallelujah. This is Pastor Mark Akiti welcoming you to the broadcast of the prophetic word. Hallelujah. 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 Make this bold confession with me today. Hallelujah. Say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for the gift of life. Thank you, O God, for my life. Thank you for my family. Thank you for my loved ones. Thank you for grace. I celebrate grace, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Today, I declare, I am not stagnated. I am not staying at the same spot. I am not remaining at the same spot. Today, I am going forward because I am a just person. I am going forward today because I am just. For the Bible says that the part of the just is as a shining light. It shines more and more. I am going forward. I am progressing in destiny. I am progressing. I am not regressing. I am a lender. I am not a borrower. I am above only. I am not beneath. I am the head. I am not the tail. I am prosperous. I am not poor. I am in plenty and abundance. I'm not in lack. All things are working together for my good. All things are working together for my good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As you have declared before the Lord, so shall he be in your life. In Jesus' name. Amen. Today, we take a step further on our discussion on divine enlargement. 2 Kings chapter 6, and I'll read from verse 1. The sons of the prophets said unto Elisha, behold, now the place where we dwell with thee is too straight for us. Let us go, we pray thee, unto Jordan, and take thence every man a beam, and let us make a place there where we may dwell. And he answered, go ye. Verse 3, and one said, be content, I pray thee, and go with thy servants. And he answered, I will go. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yesterday we said that you should get to a point where you get angry with your present level that is not good enough. Don't accept the status quo. Don't say what's gonna be and just let things be. Do something about your glorious future. Get angry with not enough. Don't accept just enough. Don't accept good. We said better is better than good, and best is better than better. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Today, we're taking another step. The second step is do something about that your glorious future. The sons of the prophets took a step. They said, let us go to Jordan. Let us move out. Make that move. Take that step. Take that step. That step depends on what your assignment is. If it's a business step, there's a process. If it's an academic step, there's a process. If you're a preacher just like me, there's a process. There's a process. You must make that move. They took that step that will usher them into the next level. Make inquiry. Make inquiries, search, ask questions, make findings, and take that step that will move you to your next level. Somebody said that if you keep doing what you have been doing before, you keep getting the same result that you've been getting before. If you want something new, do something new. Do something differently to get a different result. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm praying that God will give you inspiration, that God will give you understanding, and God will give you insight. Ideas will flood your mind. I pray for ideas, that God will fill your life with ideas. And as those ideas are coming, write them down. It may not look visible to the natural mind. It may be God just speaking to you. It may be God just giving you a unique opportunity for advancement. Praise the Lord. Secondly, the sons of the prophet said to Elisha, they said, "Man of God, we want you to go with us." Hallelujah. That's the second point. Your journey to the next level, you can't embark on that journey alone. You need God. You need the support of God. You need God. You need to carry God to your side. Let God be with you. The Bible says, if God be for us, who can be against us? Another scripture that is popular, Luke 1:37 says, with God, that connotes partnership. With God, all things are possible. Make God your partner in progress as you pursue your great future. At times, some of the young people, they think they can just do it on their own. They think they can, because they are intelligent, because they are brilliant, they think they can use their own ideas, their own wisdom to do it. And you get to a point one day you suddenly realize that you need God. And you can't do without divine enablement. And you can't do without the help of God. Without the help of God, the best of your ideas will come to nothing. Without the help of God, the best of all your labor will come to empty struggles, toilings, and tussles with no result. You need God all the way. Don't let anybody deceive you and tell you that you don't need God. It's a lie from the pit of hell. You need God. No matter how small is that project, you need God. For the very, very big projects, you even need God more than ever before. Hallelujah. 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 So remember, make that move. Remember, don't make it alone. Make God your partner in destiny. Make God your partner in progress. Connect with God. Connect with the work of God. Connect with men of God. Connect with people who pray for you. You can't do it alone. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I pray for you today in the mighty name of Jesus. The grace to recognize the ideas that God sends your way. Receive it now in Jesus' name. God, your life begins with discovery. Discover your purpose. Receive grace to discover your purpose. Discover what you should be doing on earth. Discover your area of contribution on earth in the mighty name of Jesus. Discover your need of divinity. Discover your need of the gospel. Discover your need of God. Discover your need of prophets of God. Just like the sons of the prophet realized they needed prophet Elisha. May you not ignore your own prophet that God has sent into your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you that in this journey of destiny, your boat will not capsize in Jesus' name. Your aircraft of destiny will not crash land in Jesus' name. Your vehicle of destiny will not have accident in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not stop by the wayside in Jesus' name. You will start and you will finish in the mighty name of Jesus. You will accomplish greatness that is great enough for the whole world to see in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, in closing, now, as I mentioned yesterday, the world is waiting for the manifestation of the great destiny that you carry. Don't deny this generation the blessing and the benefit of your existence. Be the man. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you want to get in touch with us, either for prayers or for counseling, Our telephone number is +234808000442. Or you can send us an email, God@answersbyfire@gmail.com. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And if God impresses it in your heart to be a part and parcel of what we are doing, of the work of God in our hands, send a short message to that effect also to the telephone number that has been given, and God will surprise you. Hallelujah. No one partners with God and remains the same. Praise the Lord. God bless you. God bless you. This broadcast is available on the Telegram platform. Our name on Telegram is Prophetic Word and Prayers. Search for Prophetic Word and Prayers on Telegram and join that channel. Praise the Lord. This broadcast is also available on YouTube. Our YouTube name is Flamites Television. Subscribe to it. God bless you. Remember to share this message to people on your contact list. Don't keep this message to yourself alone. It's for others also. Distribute these blessings to others so they can get blessed as you are getting blessed. And God is going to reward you for taking that step of being a blessing to others. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Keep marching forward. Keep making progress. Keep pushing forward in destiny. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'll see you again tomorrow morning. Shalom.